Hey guys, got a quick update for you on the Thunderbird. Getting closer to time to run in the Derby, finishing up just some odd and end stuff on the car, and it's just about finished. So today we're going to talk about hand throttles. A lot of people don't run these. I think everybody should have them because it's a very simple and very safe backup to have. If you're asking what a hand throttle is, well, simply put, it's a gas pedal you use with your hand. Very simple. A lot of times in derbies, you have your gas pedal down there, and when the frames on these cars start bending up, well, that can mess with your gas pedal. The floor of the car can actually crush in, and you can't even push your gas pedal down. Or sometimes the actual cable itself right here can break, become worn out, or it'll pop off of your carb throttle hookup right there. There's many problems that can happen. And when that happens, you can't either get, you're only putting your gas pedal down maybe halfway and only getting half the power out of your engine, or you can't even push the gas pedal at all and you just can't move. Your car's sitting in idle. So what I always do on all of my cars is have a backup hand throttle, or at least for full size. I have not bothered to put a hand throttle on the Taurus over there just because, I haven't dug deep enough down in there to find a hookup for the hand throttle. It's pretty far buried. Question for you compact people that are watching this. Has anybody ever had a throttle problem with the gas pedal on a compact car? Is that a common problem or not? I'm not sure. I do know that does happen with full-size cars. So I'm going to show you what I do for mine right here. Very simple. This green wire I'm putting in is clothesline wire. The reason I use that is because it actually has metal cable inside of it. And then it's coated in that green plastic. So it's not sharp on the outside, but it's strong on the inside. Very important feature for this, so less likely to break and rub through. All I did was looped it, and I actually ran it through right down here. See right there? It's just sticking through my throttle lever right here. This is exactly what hooks up to my actual gas pedal right there. It's right next to it. That hole was already there. I just found it and put it through. Then I twisted the wire several times around itself and put one of these U-clamps in here. Those U-clamps are very helpful. Tighten that down as tight as it can go. You do not want it to pull out when you're using the hand throttle. And it's good to go. I ran it back here. I have a pretty good-sized hole in the firewall already where the windshield wiper motor used to be. It's not sharp on the edges, it's rounded over right here, so it won't rub through. That's going to come up through my firewall, and my hood has a half circle cut in the hood right here, so I can open the hood and not hit this window bar that I have bolted and welded in. So this green cable is going to come out through that hole underneath the hood there, and I should be able to pull it just fine. Now I'm still working on finishing my handle design for it. In previous years, I had a piece of angle iron. I just wrapped it around and duct taped it in place. This year, I might try something a little bit more nice looking. Might get an actual piece of pipe or something, kind of like I did with my shifter here. Run it through that, maybe. And I'm just going to have that hanging on my dash bar right here. I'll have it duct taped in place. If I need to use it, I can rip the duct tape off and start pulling on it. That's all there is to it. You just loop it, bolt it, and pull it. Three steps. And I'll show you right here when I pull on it, you can see it working. Very simple concept. Yeah, there it is moving. Pretty easy. So yeah, that's hooked up, that's good to go. I'll put a handle on it, and that's one more thing done on this car. And knocked off my list. Also, quick idea for you guys. If you don't know about this, you know the springs that are on your carburetors right here? This is for your return lever. When you push on the gas pedal, these springs pull it back so your throttle doesn't stay stuck open. Well, I actually have three springs all right there, wound together. The reason I have that is because sometimes the old rusty ones will break and your throttle gets stuck open. Now, I never want that to happen, so I have three springs. If one breaks, the other two will keep working. And if another one breaks, I got one more still. So it should be sitting pretty good. That's why I have multiple springs wound together. That's just a quick thing to do for people if they didn't know that. You can do that on a bone stock car. Nobody really notice. Just a little helpful feature. All right, coming up next, we're going to get that ignition system changed out. I have my brand new HEI distributor ready to drop into this engine. And we'll get this whole ignition box taken out, because that thing is shorting out on the inside, causing a misfire in the engine. Stay tuned for more updates on the car.